What's up, everybody? Infernal Shard 1 for the win. Today, going to be talking about a little bit about the PlayStation 4 and how Sony has managed to win the console war of this generation. So, the PlayStation 4 was originally launched back in November 15th of 2013. It actually came out a week early before the Xbox One came out. And Sony has just managed to make this console today a much better piece of hardware than it was back then when it launched, and also a much better piece of hardware than the Xbox One. Like, you got so many exclusives, you got games that actually look slightly bit more better on the base PS4 hardware than over the base Xbox One hardware. Even though with the upgrade models, which are the PlayStation 4 Pro and, of course, the Xbox One X, the Xbox One X is going to be the supreme powerful console through the upgrades. But, and over the standard models from when these consoles first launched, the PlayStation 4 is actually the more powerful hardware over the base models. Like, you got games like this game on the screen for an existing is Grand Theft Auto 5, which actually runs at native 1080p on the PS4, and I even think it does on the Xbox One as well, but not all games will do 1080p on the Xbox One because it's just got a completely different graphics card in it than what the PlayStation 4 did. And then you also got games like Far Cry 5 and Spyro the Reignited Trilogy. Of course, Red Dead Redemption 2, Far Cry 3 Classic Edition, and I even think Far Cry 4, and then even Call of Duty World War 2. Like, all of those games on the Xbox One only run at 900p, so it's not as crystal clear as playing at 1080p, but yet again, all of those games actually run at 1080p on the PlayStation 4. And they actually perform slightly a bit more better in performance and stuff than what they do. I mean, if you look at it, the performance is technically very, very even. But because of the PlayStation 4 being a slightly bit more powerful than the Xbox One, games are actually kind of slightly performing much more better on the PS4 because, you know, it has a much better graphics card and stuff like that, and it's just all that stuff. So, yeah, and this is one of the big reasons of why the PlayStation 4 is actually winning this generation is because it is a technically a 100% native 1080p system, and that's what a lot of gamers want. When the system first launched, they didn't want to see, like, a 720p type game and, like, or in the mix between 720p to 1080p. Like, everybody was wanting a 1080p console because at the time the full HD 1080p TVs a lot of people already own when these consoles launched back in late 2013. So everybody wanted the best for resolution and performance, and the PlayStation 4 was that. The PlayStation 4 was pretty much your answer to take as the best premier console ever. So, but that's not the only thing of why the PlayStation 4, I like it more, and also why Sony is killing it with it being the best online gaming console that they have ever made. Now, the PlayStation 2 is actually the most successful console and popular console of all time. It has sold over 155 million units worldwide, and no other console has beat that record except the DS has managed to come very, very close to reaching that number, and it's only sold 154 million units. So it's right at the edge of the PlayStation 2, and they don't make them no more. So technically, the PlayStation 2 is still the top of the dog of the best-selling game console of all time. So that one is technically Sony's best-selling game console of all time, but now with the PlayStation 4, it's actually Sony's best-selling online gaming console of all time. I mean, yeah, surely the PlayStation 3 did very, very decent and did well, and it managed to come back on the Xbox 360's number of sales, and it managed to come back as an even number between both of the 360 and the PS3. But with the PlayStation 4 numbers, they're just stacking so high, it's not even funny. Like, Xbox Ones have only sold about 41, maybe 43 million units by now. But the PlayStation 4 has actually sold 90, at least from when I last checked, the PlayStation 4 sold 94 million units. So the Xbox One, Microsoft hasn't even sold half as PlayStation 4's numbers. So PlayStation 4 is really, really killing it through this generation. And then another thing of what the PlayStation 4 is really, really strong through this generation is because the fact that Sony is actually bringing exclusives, and exclusives is one of the big things about owning a game console and one of the big things about gaming. Having a game that's only for a specific platform, and when people get very, very interested in it and they see that it's only for that specific platform, then what are they going to do? Well, you actually got to think. They're actually going to go and they're going to buy that system, and they're going to be like, well, I can only play this game on this platform, so I'm going to have to go and buy this platform. And so it brings people in because there's so many good games. So a lot of the most successful exclusives on the PS4 are Horizon Zero Dawn, which actually turned 2 years old a month ago and actually sold a little over 10 million units by now. You also got the Marvel Spider-Man that just released back in September 14th, or September, early September of last year, and it actually has sold 10 million units within 6 months. And then you also, of course, got God of War that released last year in April, which actually got Game of the Year for 2018, and then a couple other awards that have started for the year 2019, and it actually took over as the Game of the Year reward for those events. So you also got Uncharted 4, also another game that came out a few years ago, which is like the most successful PlayStation 4 exclusive ever, and the game is like gorgeous. Like, it's like no other game, especially on this console. Like, it runs at 1440p on the PS4 Pro, and it actually managed to do 1080p on the base PS4. And still, even on the base PS4 at 1080p, Uncharted 4 really looks like a realistic, it just looks like a real open world game with a storytelling to it. So it's actually a very, very awesome game. And then you also got some newer exclusives coming out this year, which are Ghost of Tsushima, also The Last of Us Part 2, and then you also got Last of Us Remastered that they redid, which was the best-selling PS3 exclusive game of all time. And then you also are going to have Death Stranding that's supposed to be coming out, I think, next year sometime, or possibly 2021. And yeah, Sony's just been really killing it with exclusives. And Xbox hasn't even managed to do that many exclusives within the Xbox One's life cycle. I mean, the only exclusives that you honestly got for the Xbox One is Halo the Master Chief Collection, Halo 5 Guardians, Gears of War 4, and all of the Forza games, and then a couple other Sea of Thieves, and then Quantum Break, and it's just not enough compared to Sony having, like, big open world and big, you know, storytelling games like God of War, Uncharted 4, the Marvel Spider-Man. Like, Sony has just been really killing it with single-player exclusives, and everybody is just really, really loving it. And this is the all of these reasons right here are the reason why I would rather play the PlayStation 4 more than the Xbox One. Now, also another thing about the PS4 is that the PlayStation 4 will install your games. If you went out and you bought a physical copy of a certain game, like, say, for instance, like, you went out and you bought Grand Theft Auto 5, for example, for the PS4, and it's about 60-some gigs for just the game itself, and with the updates, it adds up to about 70-some gigs, but the game itself is literally 60-some gigs. Like, I think it's actually 66 gigabytes for just the game itself to install. Then, when you put it into your Xbox One, you would have to physically install the data, and it would take, like, almost probably, like, 30 minutes to 40 minutes just to install a game, while on the PlayStation 4, all it does, it copies that data within seconds, and then all you have to really do is pretty much update the game, and then once it's updated, you're pretty much ready to go. And that's with a lot of games, especially. So, games will attempt to install and just copy the data a lot more faster on the PS4 instead of having to physically, like, install the data. It just copies the data pretty much, and you can start up your game within a matter of seconds and it's ready to play. And then on like the Xbox One, you have to physically install it, which, like I was saying, will take 30 to 40 minutes depending on how big the game and the size that it really is, and it will just take so much time and you wouldn't be able to play it right away just like you would on the PS4. And then the last thing about the PlayStation 4, why it's much better, is because it's got a capture card built into it. So you're actually able to broadcast and record YouTube videos, Twitch or Twitter, whatever videos that you want to do, and you want to post them to YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, Twitter, or whatever. You can actually do that on here and record your headset literally at the same time if you want to just do a game video. Like, on the base models of the PS4, you can only record up to 720p, and then if you have a Pro, it will let you record up to 1080p game videos. So either way, you're still in HD, and you can record through your headset. Like, just PlayStation 4 has really, really done it right this generation, and it's the most awesome, successful console ever. So, yeah, and this is one of the big reasons why Sony has killed it, and Sony has really stayed loyal to their fans. Like, on Xbox, you don't even have much of half the stuff that Sony has. Like, Xbox, you don't have the ability to game capture and your voice at the same time. You can game capture, but you actually cannot capture your voice while capturing the video, which I think is kind of completely stupid and stupid out of the park that you can't record your headset at the same time. Like, I think it's kind of like seriously stupid. Like, they should make it to where, since they're able to record game captures, to where you're actually able to record your voice at the same time, because otherwise it doesn't make it really that good of a video that you're really wanting to create. So, yeah, Sony has really, really done it right this generation, and the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 4 Pro are literally my favorite consoles for this generation. They did an amazing job, and the console life cycle is literally almost over, probably just a little over one more year, and we're going to have the PlayStation 5 and stuff like that. So, yeah, Sony, I really want to give you guys a lot of credit. You guys have really done it right for this console. You made it such an amazing system. It's a system that I prefer and that I try to get all of my friends to get, because you guys just did everything right. So, yeah. But anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts down in the comment section down below. If you're a PlayStation 4 owner and you are a loyal PlayStation person and you love Sony and you're a loyal Sony, you know, just if you're a loyal PlayStation Sony owner and player, just let me know down in the comment section down below, guys. And I will catch up with you. And also, if you guys are new, please subscribe to the YouTube channel if you guys are new. And I will catch you guys on the next video. And also, the last part, hit a like. So, rate, comment, and subscribe. And I will catch you guys on the next video. So, peace.